Hello and welcome to the second lecture of Robotics and Electronics. I am Heath Nayak from Team RoboCart, and today's topic for the video is how to interface sensors with actuators. Basically, how to link sensors and actuators to get the desired output from the input. So let us start with the study of sensors and actuators. Sensors are devices which detect the changes in the environment and respond to some output on other system. You can relate your sensory organs such as eyes, nose, ears, tongue, etc. with sensors. Actuators are devices that make something move or operate. You can relate actuators with your hands and legs which perform physical tasks. Okay, so now I will teach you how to make an edge bridge of a motor and I will show you how to make its tabular configuration. To make an edge bridge, we will have to design a circuit with 4 switches and 2 terminals. So let us start designing. I will choose a brush. In this case, I will select this ink. Now I'll make its switches. Now I'll make a motor. For that I will choose a circle. I will write M in the circle to indicate that as a motor. I will join its second half to the circuit. And I will make its 2 terminals. Okay, so the circuit diagram is ready, and now we will have to give the points some name. So I will name this as designated digital pin 10. This will be 11. You can choose any. I chose 10 and 11. Note that these are the designated digital pins of the Arduino itself. And these are the other ends of the pin, so these will act as opposite. I will name it as 10 bar and 11 bar. Okay, so now that we have completed the circuit and designated the numbers, let us understand the flow of current in this configuration. So to make the motor rotate in the forward direction, that is, let's say this direction, we will pass a current through the terminal and designate pin 10 as high and 11 as low. The flow of current will be from, okay, so firstly I will close the circuit for the current to flow. Now when we designate 10 as high and 11 as low, the current will flow from the terminal to 10 to the motor, from the motor to 11 bar, and then to the terminal. This is the forward condition, and when we change the direction of current, that is, we change the polarity and designate 11 as high and 10 as low, the current will flow from the terminal to 11, from 11 to the motor, from the motor to 10 bar, and from 10 bar again to the terminal. So this is by changing the polarity. Now that we have noticed the forward and the backward movement of motor, we will understand the concept of stopping the motor. The motor can be stopped by either of two ways. The first one being that we do not pass a current at all through both the pins, that is 10 and 11 is kept as low. So if no current flows through the motor, there is no electromagnetic field and the rotor won't rotate. The other condition is that we designate both the pins, that is 10 and 11 as high. So this will lead to a balance of forces. Let me explain. So when we designate 10 and 11 as high, the flow of current will be like this and like this simultaneously. So when these both forces act on the motor, there will be equilibrium and the motor won't rotate. Equilibrium here stands that the forces are equal and there is no dynamic action happening. So this was the edge bridge. Now I will make its tabular form to simplify it. I will make 3 rows and 4 columns. I will name the rows as the pin number, that is 10 and 11. I will name the columns as forward, backward, and stop. So our first condition was keeping 10 as high and 11 as low to get the output in the form of a forward motion. So I will give 10 as high and 11 as low. Our second condition was changing the polarity to get the output in the form of a backward motion. So we designated 11 as high and 10 as low. So I will enter 10 as low and 11 as high. Our third condition was to stop the motor, which took place either by two actions, that is keeping both low or keeping both as high. So this was the tabular format. Now I will type Tinkercad. I will click on login. So I have already logged in and click on circuits. Then choose create a new circuit. So now we will study the actuation of a motor, the forward, backward and stopping of a motor. So for that I will drag an Arduino board and a DC motor. So as we chose the terminals 10 and 11, I will insert the pins right there. I'll change the color to red and I will change this color to black. So our circuit is ready. Let us go on to the coding part. I'll drag this set pin dash to high bar right here. I'll again drag this. I'll set the pin number as 10 and the other pin number as 11. As we saw earlier, the pin 10 was set as high and 11 was low. It was our initial condition for forward motion. I'll keep 11 as low. Now I'll introduce a delay of 5 seconds. Now I will again drag these columns right here for our further conditions. So for the second condition, 10 was low and 11 was high. I will designate 10 as low and keep 11 as high. I will change the delay as 5 seconds. So our third condition was to make the motor stop. I will set the pin as 10 this one has 11. I will change both to low, and I will change the delay as 5 seconds. So our code and circuit is completed. Let us start the simulation. So as you can see, the motor is rotating in the forward direction, and once the delay is done, it is rotating in backward direction for another 5 seconds, and now the motor has stopped. And with this, we have a task for you guys, which is a part of the competition. The competition part I will explain you in the later half. So the task is as follows. You have to design this table, just this table and not this circuit, of a car who desires to turn left or right. So basically, I will explain you that if a car wants to turn left, its left motor will remain stationary and the right motor will rotate forward in forward direction. So for that, the left motor should be designated as low, and the right motor should be high. So accordingly, you have to make this table indicating forward, backward and stationary for right and left turn with 4 pins. And you have to mail us at support@robocar.com. So let us move on to the interfacing of sensors with actuators part. For that, I will open Google and I will type Tinkercad. I will go on the website. So once you log in with your Google account, you will get a screen like this. Go on to circuits and click on the button create a new circuit. So this will lead to the main screen on which you will do the simulation. So the basic logic behind this circuit is using a sensor and an actuator for the condition to be satisfied. For that, we will choose an Arduino, a sensor, which in this case is proximity infrared sensor, also known as PIR sensor. I'll drag this PIR sensor right here. So now we will need an actuator. The actuator in this case is a buzzer. I'll drag this buzzer right here. We need a power supply for the actuator to perform its action. So we will choose a 9 volt battery. So these are the components required for this particular circuit. And once we complete the connection, we will go on to the coding part. So let us make the connections. The negative part of the battery will go to the ground pin of the Arduino. I will change its color as black. Now, the positive terminal of the battery is the voltage input for the Arduino. So I will drag that to the voltage input pin. I will change its color as red. So the connection for the battery is done. Now comes the sensor. The ground terminal of the sensor goes to the ground pin of the Arduino. So I'll change its color as black. The power pin of the sensor goes to the 5 volt input, which is right here. I'll change its color as red for simplification. You can keep it any. I'm using red and black for simplification. So now comes the output of the sensor. the output of the sensor, which in this case is a signal, will go to a designated digital pin. I will choose it as a pin number 8. I'll keep its color as green for simplification. Now comes the actuators part, that is buzzer. The positive terminal of buzzer goes into ground. So I will take it to ground. I will change its color as black. And the negative terminal of the buzzer goes to a designated digital pin. I will choose pin number 5. I will change its color as red. And this leads us to the end of the connection of the circuits. Now let us move on to the coding part. So these are the default codes. I will drag and delete them. So the condition or logic for the circuit is, if any object or a person comes in the range of this PIR sensor, it will send a signal to the Arduino, and the Arduino will process this and pass a current to the actuator for the buzzer to beep. So the condition here will be, if something appears in the range, then it will pass a current, and if not, then it won't pass a current. So we will drag this if then and else bar right here. Now we will drag a mathematical formula for the condition. So we will drag this second one right here. Now in the form of input, we will drag this read digital pin column in the first. Now we will change the lesser than sign to equal to and give the pin number 8, which is the output of the sensor, as its name. So the condition is, if read digital pin, that is the output of digital pin 8, is 1 or high, then the condition will take place, or else it won't take place. So now we will drag this set pin to high or low right here, and again we will drag it right here because the conditions are same. Just we have to pass a signal or not, the decision remains with this bar. Now I will set this pin, input pin, to the actuator as 5 because the negative is connected to 5. I'll set this as 5 also. So the first condition is, if it detects something, then it will pass a current. And the second condition is, if it does not detect, that is else, it won't pass a current. So I will change this second condition as low. So the code for this particular circuit is ready. To verify it, we will have to simulate it. So let us start the simulation. We will click on this sensor. It will show us its range and an object. You have to drag and scroll it through the entire range or even outside it. If the actuator beeps, our circuit is successful. Our connections and codes are successful. So let us try. Won't beep. It won't beep. So this means that our circuit is perfect and it's right. So you have to click on the share option, click on invite people. By clicking on invite people, you will get a link. You have to copy this link, as well as you have to record the video of your own project, and you have to share the video on our mobile application, which is free of cost. We will provide the link for the app in description. Uploading your video in the application is compulsory. So download the app, and once all the four lectures of robotics and electronics are complete, you have to submit your final project, which you have built, on our email support@robocard.com. Also, you have to upload the video of the output on our app, which is available on Play Store. And again, this is compulsory in order to participate in the competition. If you have any queries, contact us through support@robocard.com. Do share the video and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.